I don't know. I got to wait a second, don't you, Eric? This is getting to the good part. Hang on. Hold on. Work with us here. Hang on. It gets right now and wait and feel the beat right now and go.
Oh, it's the new one. Oh, it's not the old Bill Withers one.
No.
Right.
This is what we talk about at Home Wizards. Yeah. It's all about possibilities, improving your home and improve your life, and some great tunes, don't you think?
Absolutely. You're doing a great job on that music.
Like
I love what you... You could be a DJ. I don't know what you're thinking.
Oh.
Yeah, see?
Thank you, Courtney.
I know.
Well,
People love her.
Eric Stromer, Cindy, though, we want to put a smile on your face. I mean, come on. Life is... Don't take yourself so seriously. Don't take your home so seriously. We might make it simple and easy, and just when you go home, you go, you know what? I've arrived, and things are okay. So that's what we do. And here we are at the San Francisco Garden Show, where, again, gardening doesn't have to be intimidating. And we found so many great trends. What were some of your favorites, Eric, what you saw?
You know, I just love this idea of vertical gardening.
Mm-hmm.
Small spaces can be honored effectively. Areas that you thought had to just be a certain way with a couple of plants in the ground can now be walls or screens made out of unique and interesting fencing choices. Anything from old pallets that you get at a big box store and paint in a fantastic way, to, you know, these extravagant things using ipé wood, the stuff that the boardwalk on the East Coast was originally made of, one of the hardest woods around. Just great options, great ideas. And water features, I loved all the water features that we saw. And then the most important thing, I think, was this idea of honoring biodynamic gardening, the idea of recirculating things, rainwater falls. It goes into a cistern, and then that becomes a way to water your plants in the dry season. So
that's
all
the
that great stuff.
Aqua and hydroponics, which was so
yes
amazing. I mean, instead of having a swimming pool, imagine having a pond and a waterfall feature where you are not only taking care of fish but growing fish, if you will, for your own sustenance, and then that in turn helps to feed your edibles that are kind of being grown around the bin on this pond.
This could be the new thing in the Stromer home. Pa, I'm getting you some tilapia. I'll make it up real good. You know,
there you
that
go.
Could be the new...
It's a good family project.
Yeah.
There were so many great things. Edible landscaping, of course, is huge. And I think beyond that, we want to have a sense of serenity. And whether it is with water or with a little stepping stone, textures and plants, things that kind of just relax you, I feel were something that were huge. And several of our favorites are up on our Facebook page. If you go to facebook.com/homewizard, you'll see the pictures. Like, what about this walkway? It was a little pavers, and they had kind of a sky blue aqua recycled glass. It looked like icebergs.
Yes.
That they used instead of using grout.
Right.
And that was the walkway.
That was really pretty, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And again, water can seep down through that, go back into the ground,
mm-hmm.
and help irrigate certain
Beautiful.
Areas.
Beautiful.
Really pretty.
Recycled glass.
Loved
you know.
It.
And in fact, a lot of the landscape architects who were here also used this recycled glass for the outdoor fireplace. But then one in particular said, boy, she wished that she'd used this other kind of a glass because it was using what windshield glass.
Yes.
Where it's repurposing glass from a car.
That's right.
You know?
Great idea.
So that is also a big theme that we've been seeing here.
Sustainability. It's
mm-hmm.
really showing up, especially in the landscaping world, because there is such a shortage of water. So it's a great idea to start to understand and honor these principles as they pertain to us,
mm-hmm.
especially down in Southern California.
Now, about this table that I loved. It happened to be a great table to have a glass of wine. I'm just saying.
What?
Yeah.
A glass of what?
And it was a big, huge rock. Now, not everyone can get a rock in their yard, but imagine just some kind of a surface where you put a fountain in the side, in the middle of it, right? And maybe you can give us some instruction, Eric, on this, but the water came bubbling up from the center, and it looked like an infinity pool as it then shimmered over this rock that was now a coffee table out is an outdoor living room table, and then they used for fun these coasters sitting right on this maybe, you know, an eighth of an inch thick little pool of water going over. And now your wine glass is on top of the coaster that's on top of the water, and it looks like you're floating on water.
Yeah, and I think first and foremost, anything can be a fountain. This is what we saw over and over again. And we saw a lot of these polished boulders. So you'll get one of these boulders at a landscaping supply store, and you can actually shear it off, and then they'll polish it for you, much like they do a piece of granite, and it gives you that flat, smooth surface. So one side is organic, shaped like you would see it in nature, and then the top or the side can be polished to have that great look. You drill a core hole through it, bring a little fountain, a pump in it, have the water supply recirculate, and there you go. You got yourself an instant fountain.
But why not have it as a table? I mean, isn't that
you can have it as a bench. We saw them as benches, too,
yeah.
You know?
Yes.
Great uses of 4x4 timber used kind of in succession to create benches and backrests on a bench. And big. I saw a lot of big lumber used in a unique and unusual mm-hmm. way. 4x4, 6x6 posts to create furniture. Really great.
And it seems that you don't have to spend a lot of money. If it's not something that you have around the house, it could be something that you find at a salvage yard or at a garage sale to get some of these materials. And maybe you're buying a few things to mix with that.
Right.
You know, how about, speaking of water, those misters that they had in this one demonstration garden at the garden show, they had an outdoor hot tub with a gazebo and beautiful plants and ferns and orchids. But then on a timer, there were these little, like little fog machine, misters
yeah.
with beautiful outdoor garden lights that looked like little green fireflies that would shimmer with this mist that would kind of roll around the hot tub.
Well, you know what I learned from my wife, the director of Pop Tours, when you have these lights, you have to have the fog machine in order for those beams of light to show up.
Uh-huh.
And so that's
like
what
happens.
Exactly. That's what happens when we saw that mister show up, because then those lights create that great ray of light that you see
uh-huh.
going through the trees.
Like a green tunnel of light.
Yes.
And then
beautiful.
All of a sudden, and we got a great picture. We have it up on our Facebook page, /Home Wizards. It looks like little fairies floating in the
fairies.
In the garden.
Yeah.
So that, I mean, talk about serenity. That is a great thing that you can do. And if we wanted to get our own mister, how can we install our own mister? What would we do?
Well, you know, they sell these great kits now. You can actually have them, a little hose device will go up over an area like a pergola, for example, if you want it to use for cooling purposes
in the
summer.
Like in Palm Springs, you know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so they're very, you just use zip ties and you fasten the hose all the way up along some kind of a post or fence system, and bam, there you go. You have an instant misting system.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah, great.
And you could have it on a timer?
You could have it on a timer, you could have it on a switch, whatever you
want
to do.
Can I have it so that when it's like it's sensitive to motion, so that when you walk by, it's misting you in the face?
Yes, that would be appropriate for our Halloween segment. Hey, guess what? We're going to miss you when you walk through your costume.
Hey, mister.
Yep, that's it.
No, I'm just kidding. What else do we love? There were so many beautiful things. I think that the colors were amazing, too. Using plants with hard surfaces so that they kind of coordinate to, again, make it feel like you have an outdoor room. You know,
yes.
Be afraid to try chartreuse with burgundy or, you know, some really grounded, beautiful, creamy taupe colors. But then that limestone, that little serenity pool filled with those rocks, those tumblers that were maybe the size of your hand.
Mm-hmm.
And it had that kind of a seafoam green. It was beautiful.
Really was beautiful.
It had a very relaxing look to it. And speaking of that specific garden, what were those walls made of? It looked like a redwood, and it created, again, a sense of dimension and boundary as you walked across that serenity pool with those green rocks over to the side by the fireplace.
Oh, yeah. You know what those were? Those were redwood strips.
Mm-hmm.
They were about an inch and a half wide by a quarter inch thick, and you can buy those obviously at big box stores as well. And they kind of fed those around a post in the center, so that it gave you this idea of almost like a modern Japanese origami sculpture, and that became your fencing.
So here's what you do. Map out your outdoor living room, sketch it out, prepare the floor for your outdoor living room, add an element that mimics maybe a ceiling for shade, think about water, think about furniture, think about a focal point in color, and yes, of course, plants, and just have some fun with it. I mean, there's so many options. I think it's really exciting.
Absolutely.
You know?
There's nothing but possibilities in your garden right now today. Take a look at some of the stuff at yourhomewizards.com for inspiration.
Yeah.
You'll see some great photos, and I know it'll inspire you guys like it did us.
And it's going to really extend the time that you spend outside, you know. You're going to feel that now living outside is not just an occasional thing, but it's where you love to live. And layer everything with color and your personality with containers of flowers, and don't forget the candles and the pillows and all that.
Let's do it. I'm doing it. I'm going to go. I'm flying home. Actually, we're flying home in a couple of hours.
Yeah.
And I'm going to actually go deal with my
garden.
You're
going to do it?
Yeah.
It's very exciting. And please,
By the way, you know, you inspire me to clean. I like told you, I ran out of dumpster. It was huge. I got rid of all my garbage. It inspired me.
You inspired me. I'm going to put
you
in mysteries.
Complete me.
Oh, you're my friend.
Oh, you are.
You nut. All right, well, hey, email us and let us know what you want us to tell you to help complete you in a fun way for your home, to improve your home and improve your life. YourHomeWizards.com is the website. Thanks for sharing part of your day with us. We love having you with us. And until next time, remember this. The key is under the mat. Bye-bye. Here together.
I'd say that was a pretty successful broadcast.